Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Zane from Legends United, and today we are going to talk about if the real money offers are scams or actually worth to buy. Real money offers are ruling us Fortnite ever since the beginning of the game and created lots of controversial situations already. But today, I decided I will give you a little help if these packs, what you can see here, are any of them are worthy or actually you should never buy these things because they might be scams. We should talk about, first of all, that depends on the certain people and depends on who is richer and who is poorer. They can all buy these real money offers. Nobody should shame the other only because they spend money on a game. It's their decision. It's their choice. If they want to, they can do it. If they don't want to, they don't have to do it. Like, simply that's all. So I just wanted to clear that please don't shame others because they decided to spend money on something. Because, you know, sometimes they can be more determined, more sure they want to get a certain car no matter what, so they can do that. And now, let's talk about the classic $5 packs. It's my currency is not dollars, but I can assure you, this 1,725 is $5. And the 6,900 is around $15. And that 700 is $2 or $3 actually, I'm not sure. I think 2.99. Okay, so from the outside there is no much difference from this pack, so you have to pick in all the packs. As we can see, for example, the Aventador J-Pack is giving 200 tokens, 20,000 credits and 5 blueprints. So most of you are saying that, okay, this is a joke, like, okay, this for $5, this, leave me alone, I don't need it. So yes, most of you are doing that, and for me it's also fine that you are getting only 20,000 credits, it should be 200,000, and five blueprints. But if you are looking at different cars, the 1,700 packs are not the same, aka the $5 packs. For example, here, the TVR, you only get 150 tokens and 50,000 credits and 10 packs. And same goes actually for the Infinity. You are getting less for your money than, for example, with the SLR and Aventador J. So what's the first thing we learned about that? Yes, for usual packs, what you have the $2.99 offer for offers less when you buy the $5 more, no matter what you are doing. Oh, by the way, they prepared the shop glitch. So yeah, this is the first thing you have to know. And there are other packs as well, which are not coming in $5 but only $10. These are the ones which are not really worth to buy it. For example, the Chinese pack is also coming at $5 pack and a $10 pack as well. So, the next question is, any of these are worth it or they are big scams? Depends actually, because let's talk about the $5 packs only, because there are some $2 packs which are coming with a very good offer, but we are talking about that later. First of all, the $5 packs. So in general, $5 packs are not giving you as much as you imagine. You think you are getting a lot, but actually you don't. From these $5 packs, you can ask if these special themed ones are worth it more. For example, these or only the car ones. Where if you are thinking about buying a $5 pack from the shop, only the car ones are worth it. And only the ones which are old cars. For example, here, Aventador G and SLR, you get more for your $5. But you would get for the TVR or for the Infinity. The question is why? Why are you getting less for D-class cars than for example, a B-class car or an A-class car? Well, it's pretty simple. First of all, Infinity and TVR need less blueprints to unlock. So you think it's worth it if you buy these more. Well, actually, if you are close to start up a car, okay, no, we are talking about later. So, you're getting more here, but you think you are getting more here because These cars need more blueprints to get started up or max it. That's why you're getting three blueprints more, 50 tokens more. But actually, you're getting less credits if you're looking at the fact by 30,000, and you're getting team packs 10 times, like 10 team packs. And now we are talking about, are these worth it? Some of them, yes, some of them do worth it, even though, for example, the Infinity Pack, this $5 pack's worth it. Why? Why do I say an Infinity Pack worth it when the drop rate is terrible and they are forcing you to spend real money in order to get blueprints? It only worth it, only worth it. Do not skip this part. I didn't say it worth it completely, I said only worth it if you are 5, 6, 5, 4 blueprints away from starting up, then you might buy this pack because the Infinity Pack might give you one or two blueprints. That depends on, well, this one is basically having not guaranteed blueprints, so for your own danger, you can get 15 from that only, I think, or not 15 only. Let's see. No, you can get 3 as well, and the drop rate for that is 50 for rare. So you have a bit bigger percentage to get the Infinity. I mean, not really, as you can see, not the biggest chance. But yes, if you need like a small amount of blueprints and you are very determined to get this car, then you can buy it. These packs might save your special event progress. Why I mean that, I will show you in a second. And the same goes for these cars as well. Why am I saying that? How can a pack save a special event progress? Very easily. As you can see, these cars, the first three cars, are having the packs in the shop. Let's go forward a bit. For example, you are in the state as me, like having the SLR at 4 stars, you need it at 5 stars, you need 9 blueprints. But let's say the club rewards already collected, the Legend Pass content is already collected, and the multiplayer is as well, and the packs are not giving you SLR. This car can decide your fate, for example. So here we can see 8 Inferno blueprints, and let's say you have completed all of them, you need 8 to unlock this car. You are against pay to win, but these 5 blueprints might mean, let's say you have, by the way, like you need exactly 5. And this might save your progress. So what are you doing? You are buying the pack, you are getting the 8 blueprints, and you are unlocking the Inferno. Let's not forget about you are getting 300 tokens and getting 5 times 150,000 credits. Yes, this means basically 750,000 credits if you complete these 3 races. So now you not only spend $5 on the SLR and just spent money and supported Gameloft, but for that offer you are getting 300 blueprints. That would be great. 300 tokens plus and 750,000 credits as well. So in the end, oh, you are getting 770,000 credits and 500 tokens for the 5 blueprints and also for the 10 packs of SLR blueprints. Like that, it's worth more, can you see? And same goes to that. Same goes exactly for the Aventador J. If you are checking it, here you can, not here, sorry. Where is it? Here's the Aventador J. For example, you get the same. You get the same amount. I have it max, fortunately. And yes, you are getting another 200, I mean 300 plus tokens, 750,000 credits, and then you got more actually what you paid for. You paid for this, but you are getting a gratis, aka bonus, 300 tokens, 750,000 credits, sorry, and 8 blueprints for the Inferno car. Can you see? Can you see why it is worth it sometimes? And if you're talking about these packs, like the Infinity, like, okay, this one is does not worth it too much. 150 tokens, 50,000 credits, and only two blueprints, like, everyone can save it. It's a joke. Like, what the? This is not normal. But let's say you are very lucky. Like, you are very lucky. And you're getting a good drop from the special event, which is nearly impossible. I have this, by the way. If you would be able to max it or three-star it, if you get, let's say, you're being very lucky, you're spending money on this game, and if you need like four blueprints to unlock it, or yes, let's say four blueprints, and let's say you're being lucky and you get three from the non-guaranteed pack from this. And once again, we are going back. And what are you getting exactly for your money when you spent it? 200 tokens, 500,000 credits, and also 8 Inferno blueprints, and also 2 Inferno epics. Can you see what I mean? Can you see what I wanna mean? That it's for the first time I am saying that sometimes it's worth to buy these things. And the main reason, because you're getting more what you think you are getting, you just have to think forward. And sure, anyone who is watching this video, I'm not encouraging anyone to buy these packs. I'm not saying you must buy these packs, and I'm not saying you should buy these packs. It's your decision, it's your choice. You are not being forced to that. And I don't want anyone to buy these offers because I said these things and then end up having one or two blueprints short, but spent all their money and then complain to me or to anyone that I lied to them. These are for your own risk. It's not guaranteed that these packs here are giving you the required amount. If you are close and if you calculated it out, then you can buy them. Yes, but I don't want anyone who is requiring 20 more blueprints to start up a car and buy like $1 $5 pack. Then later on, they are telling me that why the hell they didn't get what I promised, because I didn't promise anything. That's why. So just please, I hope everyone will know that and everyone will hear that. So that was today's video, and the final question and the main question of the video: are the packs worth to buy? For special events, if you are close to start up a car, yes, it does work because you are getting more for your money than what you expect. In general, do these packs worth to buy? No, they don't. Why? Because you are barely getting anything for your money, and those five, for example, here are those five blueprints, the 200 tokens, the 20,000 credits, and the 10 packs. Just let me say something. The five blueprints can be earned from the multiplayer after reaching a certain amount of series score for free. 200 tokens can be earned under 4 days if you are only doing the daily tasks and they are completing everything. 20,000 credits can be completed under one round of credit heist. So you can get the resources cheaper, faster, and sooner. But for this special event, this Inferno, you might start to think about if you are wanting to buy some of these if you are close. If you are close, yes, I said that twice, because that might make the chance, I mean the your chance bigger to unlock the special event car. So this was today's topic for today's video. I hope everyone enjoyed it. Feel free to ask any kind of questions. I will answer to everyone, like seriously everyone, but you can ask anything. If you enjoyed this video, then put a like on it, and if you want to see more videos, then please subscribe on my channel. And if you don't want to miss any kind of videos from me, then hit the notification bell so you will be notified about every kind of video I'm uploading, and you will never miss a single one. I was Zane from GS United. See you guys in next video. Till then, take care of yourself and goodbye.